Hello YouTube. This episode, we rejoin the road trip at the Virginia-North Carolina border.
Once again, we are crossing state lines. Virginia is for lovers. Interesting marketing.
We passed through Richmond and decided to take a hot chocolate break as we approached Washington, D.C.
Merge onto Virginia 619 East, then make a U-turn at In Street.
And that's it. That's Quantico. Don't even want to go near the security entrance. Just get back to the freeway.
Gotta hand it to Google Maps, sending me to a Starbucks that is inside a military training facility. Well, I got to see Quantico. Or at least a sign that said Quantico. I guess it's fun to say that I was there.
And I can say the same thing about the CIA headquarters at Langley. Jesus Christ, that's Jason Bourne. We might have gone a bit overboard. We are in Washington, D.C., the capital of the United States. We're walking down the National Mall where we have the Washington Monument, the United States Capitol where the House and Senate take place, as well as the White House.
That's Obama's house.
There were assorted protests in front of the White House, and next door was the Treasury Department. Don't ask me what I think of their bonds. We weren't allowed to film many parts of the Capitol, but it was a great place to learn about history, the present, and where we might be going. I had a lot of fun spending time with the family, but it was time to continue the journey north. We're here at Fort McHenry in Baltimore. And this place is known as the birthplace of the Star-Spangled Banner, which you might also know as the United States National Anthem. This thing, which looks like something out of a Dementor's wet dream, is actually a map of the Chesapeake Bay, from Norfolk, Virginia, past Washington, D.C. to Baltimore. This was the path the British ships followed to attack Fort McHenry. And here we are at the Baltimore Harbor. Check it out. The initial plan was to drive straight to Philadelphia, but as a chocolate lover, I couldn't miss visiting Hershey. It would have been nice if the factory tour was more than just a mock-up, but I would recommend the chocolate tasting experience. Walked down the Benjamin Franklin Parkway, got a photo with the Liberty Bell.
And then we ended up here at Independence Hall in Philadelphia, where the Declaration of Independence was signed.
Photos were fine, otherwise you guys would be in real trouble now, right? All right. This room undoubtedly is the most important in the nation's history.
It's where the Declaration was signed in 1776. As the sun set, we entered New Jersey, where we'd gear up to hit the Big Apple. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for the next episode and click here to watch the previous one.